throws will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I will find out starting in today's game between the Virginia Tech Hokies and the Connecticut Huskies.
We need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Huskies, by all accounts, should have an easy time of it tonight, Dick Vitale. How do they ensure that victory, though?
They should listen to me and follow the simple keys, baby. Number one, control the tempo of the game. I look for the point guard to be the floor general out there. Next, you gotta pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby. Third, make your team think defense first. Solid defense will lead to good offense.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. There's a double team waiting there. Contact on the shot attempt causes the misfire. Both teams are looking to get something going here.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Puts up the tray. That's good.
Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. From way outside. Off the rim and no good. He keeps his dribble as they reset. The center takes the feed. And the ball goes out of bounds. The post flashes up high if he wants it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. The shooting guard with the ball.
Got to make that, baby. Had a wide open angle and a chance to lay it on the glass for an easy deuce.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
Double team now, bad angle. He missed the jumper off the nice screen.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups.
He's got to get rid of it.
And up.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Manning is emotionally pumped up.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
He's got some room. Rejects it.
He went up and knocked it away.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. The point guard takes the pass. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Barber pounded on his way up. Just good, solid first half NCAA tournament basketball, Dick. That's all this one's come down to. Two good teams. They belong here, and they're playing like it.
I tell you, what makes the NCAA so special is the fact that one bad night, the party's over. And it's going to be a shame that one of these clubs are going to go to the locker room, and their season's going to be all over.
Both free throws go. The Huskies are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. The shot from the baseline. Way off target. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
A whistle and a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
High post flasher is open. The center gets the pass. Jumps in. Too much contact there. It knocked him off balance a little. He's got the post flashing if he wants it. On the inside. Looking for contact. And he scores despite the hack. The ball goes out of play. high post player flashing. Down inside, he shoots from the angle. Makes the shot.
That's worth another look.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Got the shot if he wants it. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. The shooting guard gets the ball. Off the rim and no good. Now trying to feed the low block. Up fake. Executes the baby hook. Can't get the shot to go. They're working around the perimeter.
Human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
They work the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
At the end of the first half, the Huskies lead by three. Connecticut gave a great rebounding performance in the first half of this one, partner.
I'll tell you, great effort and great poise. That's a sign of a championship team, if you ask me.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I can hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Here's a flash from the high post. Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
And now they'll bring it up. Dumps it in. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
And a momentary look from three-point land. And the ball goes out of play. He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. On the dribble, gives it up. He pump fakes.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Trying to feed the low block. He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
Barber fakes the shot. For the bucket. They still don't score. They go into the low block. White receives the pass. Number 21, pump fakes. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
High post flashes. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, you spin back the other way.
Nice shot fake. He lets it go.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Try to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
The UConn student section, also known unofficially as the Huskies faithful. They had a lot of success over the years.
Hey, the coach does a great job here. He's got an eye for potential and talent.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Here's a flash from the post up high. Intercepted. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron. High post flashes for the ball handler. For the deuce. He puts it in with contact and all. Timeout's been called. So let's check in with Aaron.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
Aaron's right about that.
Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
It's a one-point game.
1 point usually means free throws, Brad.
The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. He posterized them. Take a look right here. He explodes to the basket.
Goes to the line. Good.
Timeout's called on the floor. This is where the true players come to play. It's crunch time, baby.
We go. They've got a player spotting up on the three. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Makes it.
We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. The shooting guard gets the ball. He unloads, sinks it.
excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
That's how they waste any time. They've got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn. That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Postel handles the pass. Well, Vic, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Them both.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Shot clock is dead. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor.
With a foul. Oh, and look at the crowd, and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Well, here's a look at the turnover situation, Dick. Probably one of the stats that coaches really care about the most.
I'll tell you, definitely, Brad. Turnovers are missed shot opportunities. And without shot opportunities, winning games becomes difficult. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Bruce handles the feed. Looking for a screen on top and got it. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
The small forward receives the ball. The two ball's good. We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. He tries the buzzer beater. He misses from beyond the arc. Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you got to win it. Keep on going to get that final Monday night neighbor.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
The Hokies is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler. Good night, everybody.